My name is Herbie Miller, and I'm the director curator of the Jamaica Music Museum at the Institute of Jamaica. As most of you in the diaspora would know, the Institute of Jamaica is a 135-year-old institution and the umbrella organization for much of Jamaican culture, cultural institutions, including the National Gallery and others. So the Music Museum is a part of that. It's its most recent division. I'm tasked with bringing together, in reality, this museum. As you can see here, I'm standing beside a guitar belonging to the great Henry Jones, who created this first solid body electric guitar way back in the 1940s, a couple of years before the great Les Paul patented his guitar. So why this is arguably the first electric guitar is that a full 2 years before Les Paul's, a photograph of Hedley Jones with this guitar was actually in the Daily Gleaner. So if that's not sufficient evidence, I don't know what is. He made a number of these guitars during the war years and sold them to soldiers of the United States Army that were here in Jamaica at places like Vernon Field. All of them had their own little bands and so on, and it was a great little instrument for them to perform on with a homemade amplifier that Mr. Jones also developed. Over here we have an akete drum, or repeater drum as it's called. It's a drum used by Rastafarian musicians. This particular drum belonged to the great Scatolite drummer, master drummer, Lloyd Nibb. Indeed, you can see his name is written in red, gold and green on the drum. The bamboo flute is indigenous, or identified rather, with our mentor musicians, but it goes all the way back to the plantation days. It's just a joint of bamboo with the holes so placed that they can be played in tune. This is a replica of what Sir Hans Sloane, way back in the 1700s, identified on the island of Jamaica as a strum. Of course, it simply means that Hans Sloane saw some African Jamaicans strumming this instrument. It is also considered the forerunner to what the banjo that we look at in a moment is all about. As you can see, it's a gourd which is covered with goat's skin and stringed with some nylon to make the sound. So it's called a strum in Sir Hans Sloane's language, but we would prefer to call it a banjo. We have here a banjo, and it's on loan to us at the Jamaica Music Museum. It's a beautiful instrument, and it is one of the instruments associated with the mento style of music. It's in private hands now, but we are negotiating to have it in the collection sooner than later. Over here we have Sugar Belly's, or one of Sugar Belly's bamboo saxophone. And for those of you who heard his music way back, you can still get it on recordings and CDs. You'll realize how sweet this bamboo saxophone sounded. Sugar Belly. The Jolly Boys, who just catapulted to international fame, have been around for perhaps over 50 years. And so they made available to the museum this great rumba box, or marimba box. And of course, you know, this is the part of the mento music that plays the bass. From the Jolly Boys. So, you know, we receive a lot of donations to the museum in terms of artifacts. We really would love to see this museum grow and that we be able to establish it as the foremost institution for the dissemination of the history of Jamaican music. Researchers, movie makers, all of these kinds of folks who want to know where the music came from, what it is about, who are the persons involved. A first-class music museum.